Hello everybody, it me Scoop, and honestly, as Christmas time approaches, I figured that I did a Halloween special, I should probably do a Christmas special. And maybe one day we'll do Christmas Halloween, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa. Is it a little strange I'm doing a Christmas special when I have the Jew and I didn't do a Hanukkah special? No, it's not, because have you ever seen a Hanukkah TV special? At least one that's ever been good, because I certainly have it. Anyway, I love Christmas spirit. I don't think there's anyone out there who doesn't love Christmas spirit unless their heart is dead on the inside, but that's a different story. And so I figured why not take a look at probably my favorite Christmas story, one that I've seen year after year after year since I've been a little kid, Prep and Landing. Now, for whatever reason, Prep and Landing does not have a lot of information on the internet about it. I mean, it's not like a ghost. I just mean if you search Prep and Landing on YouTube, pretty much nothing comes up except for some cam clips of the show for whatever reason. So I figured why not spread some awareness and hopefully some of you out there actually remember watching Prep and Landing and go check it out because it's currently streaming on Disney Plus, at least in America. So there's actually three Prep and Landing shorts on Disney Plus, but I'll only be talking about two of them because I could only acquire the footage for two of them. And the third one, anyway, is just kind of a little 8-minute short as opposed to a 22-minute full episode. So I'll just, you know, skim over that really quickly. So if you've somehow never seen Prep and Landing, or just it's been many, many years and you don't remember, it's the story of two elves who, as the title would imply, go to the houses on Christmas before Santa arrives, prep the whole place, and get Santa to land safely so he can deliver the presents. And it's actually a really cute and creative concept because it plays with that idea of how does Santa get to 7 billion houses in one night? Except, that kind of forgets the fact that some people don't celebrate Christmas, but that's okay, we'll excuse it for now. So, the two main characters are Wayne and Lanny, probably, I think it's Lanny, I'm gonna say Lanny, it looks like it's spelled Lanny, but I think they call him Lanny, like, once or twice, but it's okay. So, Wayne and Lanny are two partners for the Prep and Landing squad. Wayne has been at this game for a very long time, and in the introduction in the first episode, you kind of just see him, you know, go through the motions of it all. He's a little excited by it, but year after year gets kind of stale, which I think anyone who does the same job year after year can attest to, which is valid. And he decides that it's time. He's gonna get the big promotion. He's gonna be director of the naughty list. That just sounds really stupid, but, you know, when you're watching the show, you feel for him. He's kind of a dickhead, as you see, as he kind of goes through Santa's workshop, North Pole area. And obviously, he doesn't end up with a promotion, as you would expect, because that's how the story's got to go. And he has to go back to doing Prep and Landing.
Hey, that's the name of the show.
I think, overall, the general animation of this, considering it was a made-for-TV special from 2009, is actually pretty decent. Some stuff, yeah, obviously looks a little aged. I'm pretty sure it's only in 720p. And, you know, some stuff like that, but overall it's pretty solid. There's some cute stuff with how they have the cookie scanner that really does most of the work for them, but it's got a bunch of different settings on it that are really cool. Like, it checks if creatures are stirring, and it checks if there's nuts in the cookies, and the temperature of the milk, and all that kind of really goofy stuff. This entire episode is basically just Christmas jokes, so if you don't like puns, get out now.
It's jingle time.
Instruments are holly jolly.
We are go for partridge.
I've made the list, sir.
You checked it twice?
Per redundancy protocol.
Frostbite.
And then there was also just some, like, cool general sci-fi stuff that I don't know what it was, but I actually really enjoyed, like, how it projects a hologram of how big the toy is going to be, so the elves know how much of the tree to, like, shave off to make sure the present fits. That's kind of cute. I like that stuff. They drive around on snowmobiles, so that's kind of obvious, but, you know, it's a 20-minute Christmas special. I'll take the world building I can get here. So yeah, Lane doesn't get the promotion and he meets his new partner, Lanny, who's, you know, the new guy straight out of college. They say something that Wayne has been doing this job for like 215 years, which makes me have to question how old someone would be who's just getting out of college in the elf world. When, I mean, yeah, you could tell Wayne is obviously a little bit older, but I mean, they're elves, like, I don't know, it's kind of odd, but we're gonna just skip over that question. So yeah, Lanny's like the stereotypical new guy who's like super excited, kind of dumb, but he, you know, really hardworking, that kind of stereotype, as opposed to Wayne. You know, you understand the dynamic, I don't think I have to explain it to you, but it's done well for what it is. I like the idea that obviously it's like, you know, just delivering toys to kids on Christmas, but they make it like extremely high tech and tactical and, you know, very heavily planned out and stuff. That's kind of the whole gist of the show. But as you see them kind of go through it here, and Wayne's going through the motions and Lainey's taking it super seriously, it kind of elevates the humor of the whole situation. So yeah, Lainey gets to doing all the Christmas stuff. He doesn't do it very well, while Wayne just kind of goofs around and doesn't take it seriously and ends up getting caught by Timmy, the little kid that they're supposed to be delivering the present to. I don't know why little kids are always Timmy, especially Timmy Twirlip, the double T. it's a weird trend, but it happens a lot, so I figured I should just mention it here. So yeah, Wayne gets caught by the little kid, and then we meet the rest of the reindeers that are going to be carrying Santa around on Christmas, and it has my favorite joke in the entire two-episode special right here, because it's just so stupid and silly, but like funny at the same time.
Rev up the engines.
Yeah! It seems like Santa's overly focused on this one child out of like hundreds of millions, if not like a billion people who are celebrating Christmas. But okay, yeah, Timmy Twirlip's gotta get his happy ending here. So Lainey and Wayne put Timmy back to bed after knocking him out with a fucking smoke bomb. And they have a little spat. They have a bit of an argument where Wayne throws some dirt in Lainey's eye about how he doesn't really care if Timmy Twirlip gets his happy Christmas because he's been at the job too long and he got passed over for the promotion and that whole thing. But then Lainey actually has a really nice speech where he talks about how it's not really about Wayne, it's about making the kid happy and making sure he gets his nice Christmas morning with his happy gift, because that's what any kid really wants. And it's really sweet and wholesome, because as like stupid and surface level as these two specials are, they actually do that emotional Pixar Disney gut punch moment pretty well, so I give them a lot of credit for that, especially for a 22 minute special. So Wayne has a change of heart and he's like, oh my god, we gotta get Santa to this house. And then they realize there's a giant snowstorm, so Santa can't get to the house, and they're not moving fast enough to get Santa to the house because Santa can't see, and neither can the reindeer, and they're not on the roof yet because Timmy woke up, and it's a whole thing, and Wayne is like, no, we're gonna get this done. Timmy Twirlip is getting his Merry Christmas. So they get up on the roof, and the way it works is they shoot these two lines out to form a landing strip on the roof for Santa and the reindeer to see, which I like is cool. And then it has a string guy in the middle, and Santa Claus's sleigh has a hook that catches onto it to bring him to a safe stop. And I appreciate the amount of work that the writers put into this to actually make it seem realistic and actually think about the logistics of how Santa Claus work. Like, they have these little spray things that spray air to puff up the stockings, put out the fire, stuff like that, which is cool. But then they notice that across the street, this house is overly decorated for Christmas, and because no one likes the people that do that, they decide to steal all the Christmas decorations, as any good Samaritan would, and use it as their landing strip. The music here is getting pretty intense. It does that, you know, regular show Christmas special, the thing that's always in Christmas specials, when since like the... You get the gist of it. And Lainey almost gets impaled by icicles, so that's fun. But then, you know, Wayne swings in like Spider-Man, which is something these episodes like to do a lot. They get these little grappling hooks and they like to swing around like Spider-Man. I don't know, sure, why not? I'm in a very big Spider-Man mood this week, so I'll take it. They shoot this like snow globe up into the air, and Wayne uses his little Christmas cookie iPad device to turn it green and red, so Santa knows where to land. They bring Santa to a stop safely, and little Timmy Twirlip gets his happy ending, which is sweet. So then the next day, our boy Wayne has to go see Santa, because obviously, you know, Wayne was messing around, he made a mess of the kitchen, he ate Santa's cookie, he got caught by a kid, he's on the naughty list. So he goes to see Santa, and Santa's like, Wayne, like, come on, man, not everybody's perfect. You have some moments where you get angry, you do some stuff that you didn't really want to do, but you made up for it in the end, and, you know, that's what it means to be a good person. And that's a very nice message for a kid's Christmas special, and I like it. And then Santa gives Wayne a little snow globe so he can see the happy ending he got, just to, like, double, triple, quadruple reinforce that message of make the kid happy is, you know, doing the right thing, and that's really why you do the job. Wayne gets offered the promotion he wanted. I mean, he wanted director of the naughty list. He got director of the nice list. I'm sure he doesn't really care about that. But he turns it down because he's more of a prep and landing guy.
Hey, that's the name of the show.
So yeah, it's a very cliche kind of ending, but it's sweet, it's cute. I love this Christmas special. The animation is pretty good for what it is, all that kind of jazz. And they end it with this kind of running gag that no one wants fruitcake because fruitcake is disgusting. I've never tried fruitcake. because I don't really do Christmas, because I do Jew. It doesn't look very good, but Lainey's happy with it, because that's in his character, so that's a sweet little ending. So that special aired in 2009, as I said before, and the next one aired in 2011. There was one in between Prep and Landing, Operation Secret Santa, where Mrs. Claus wants to get a gift for Santa Claus, but the gift is in his office, so Wayne and Lainey need to sneak in while Santa's taking a nap and steal this little thing from him. It's like 8 minutes long, there's not a whole lot that happens, but it's good for what it is as well. I'm not sure what happened that they gave it a 22-minute episode to begin with, cut it down to 8 minutes, then went back to 22 for the third and final episode, but, you know, I'll take what I can get. I love me some Prep and Landing, as you guys can tell. So, Prep and Landing, Naughty vs. Nice came out 2 years later. Like I said, it's a very direct sequel to Prep and Landing, as you might expect, where Lainey and Wayne have to go into a house to steal a fruitcake device back, which is kind of like the Christmas cookie, but instead of the Prep and Landing guys using it, it's the coal elves who use it, who obviously give coal to the bad kids instead of presents, because the kid's trying to take themselves off the naughty list, and it's causing all these issues. So that's actually a very unique setup, I would say. I think the coal miners are, they're a little violent. They have these freaking machine guns that they shoot at the dogs and the kids and stuff that attack them. Like, Jesus Christ, coal miners, relax. I call them coal miners because, yeah, they're coal elves, but they're just dressed like coal miners. I don't know what to tell you. And it's also kind of funny because the opening scene to Naughty vs. Nice serves as a direct foil to the opening scene of the original Prep and Landing, where it's Wayne and whoever's old partner was kind of going through the motions of getting a good kid his gift versus a coal elf going through the motions of having to give a bad kid coal instead of a present, which was kind of a smart intro. This episode also shows you a lot more of the world of Prep and Landing, how there's, you know, assembly teams and transport gift teams to make sure it's going where it needs to go in Santa's sleigh, and teams to monitor the Naughty versus Nice list, and tech teams, and that kind of stuff. So, like I said, I'll take the world building. Also, these movies have a couple of inappropriate jokes I forgot to mention. The first one especially, there's a bit of an interesting one where Wayne is trying to convince McGee, the head secretary, Santa Claus leader, elf lady person, that was a very good description of what she does, to put Wayne on the phone with Santa to make sure Santa knows that he has to arrive to Timmy's house. Younger me did not understand what this meant. He was very curious as to what could have occurred between the two elves. He didn't get it. Now I get it. And oh boy, that's a lot for a kid's Christmas special now, isn't it? But anyway, back to Naughty vs. Nice. Wayne and Lainey are sent in with Wayne's younger brother, who is a coal elf, and there's some, you know, brotherly competition between the two. His brother buys the car that Wayne was just about to buy before he was called on the mission, and he's always just generally showing him up. He doesn't use a parachute when he dives in, because I guess they're both just Captain America now, except Wayne misses the landing and freaking dies. What the fuck? Wayne's brother is actually friends with that really mean reindeer. I forget if it's Dancer or Prancer. I think it's Prancer, because haha, funny, stupid name, is such a tough guy, but whatever. And Wayne is not friends with him. Sad boy hours. So they get in, and Noel, Wayne's brother, just, you know, he's just trying to do the job, get it done. And Lainey's obviously very impressed with him because he's a cool guy. But, you know, Wayne isn't having none of it, and he's just trying to do the job himself because he wants to be Elf of the Year, which is kind of like an Oscar, but it's for elves. I guess it's more like Time's Man of the Year, but with elves. That's probably better than an Oscar, but for Society of Elves. So the two are competing, and it's eventually revealed after Lainey gets kidnapped by the kid who stole the fruitcake that it's not a boy, it's a girl. No. So obviously Lainey is in danger of getting cooties. No, I'm just kidding, that's not what happens. I don't really know why they bothered with this plot twist. You just assume it's a boy, I guess. I mean, as a kid, I assumed it was a boy, and I felt shocked by that it was a girl. I don't know why. I mean, rewatching it, I was just like, okay, like, it's a girl. I mean, yeah, I assumed it's a boy, but who really cares? And it's actually really kind of a sad story. The reason she's on the naughty list is actually never explained. She doesn't really do anything naughty except for steal the toy. But I think the idea is that she gets blamed for the stuff her one-year-old brother does. Except, by the time she would have stolen the fruitcake, because it's a year before the episode takes place, her younger brother would have been 2 months old, because I think she says exactly, like, 14 months ago, something about no one's been paying attention to her. And I don't really know if a two-month-old baby is getting a lollipop stuck under the couch and drawing on the wall and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, maybe he ripped up a stuffed animal, but that's a little sus there. So the girl's just trying to take her name off the naughty list because she's not really doing anything wrong, and she's upset that she's not getting as much attention now that she has a younger brother. So obviously that's supposed to connect to the Wayne and Cole brother story arc, where Wayne is really jealous of his brother and blah, 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 blah. You get the idea. And the girl actually manages to put herself on the nice list, but because technology, she starts putting the entire world on the naughty list, which is exploding Christmas. So they have to rewire the fruitcake and stick it to the nearest antenna for it to establish connection with the elf satellite to ensure that all the kids are put back on the nice list and Santa can do his job. I'm starting to see why this didn't get another sequel. And for whatever reason, the girl actually like works with the elves instead of them knocking her out like Timmy and putting her back in her bed. They just let her run around and know elves and Santa and all that stuff exists. But before they go save the world, Wayne and his brother have a bit of a spat again, because Wayne says he wishes his brother was never born. And his brother has the real sad boy hours over this, as a brother would. But then his brother reveals he got Wayne this toy they wanted as kids for Christmas. It's explained earlier in the episode. I skipped over it because it's whatever. It's just part of that brotherly annoyance backstory. And Wayne feels like a dickhead because he was being a total dickhead. And then they make up for it. And they save the Christmas. The end. I mean, yeah, I really did skip over a lot of stuff at the end. It was weirdly Spider-Man-ish again at the very end with all the bright lights, and they're using their grappling hooks to climb up a wall and stick into a radio tower, and the big swing and the whoosh, except instead of a thwip, they use the toy's grappling hook instead of just their normal grappling hooks. I don't know, man. It's part of the brotherhood thing, so that's, you know, it's whatever. And in the end, the two brothers are reunited as family, and they both win Elf of the Year. So they're elves of the year, but they have to split the trophy, I guess. But it's okay, because they can share. They're good brothers. So, overall, Prep and Landing, it's an interesting show. It's definitely a really cute idea, and the first episode was definitely executed extremely well, especially considering it was probably a somewhat low budget, just like ABC 22-minute Christmas special. The second one, definitely a little bit weaker. The actual brother stuff in it is pretty good. It's just the plot is very odd with the whole everyone's getting put on the naughty list, so we have to rewire the fruitcake. I can't even say it with a straight face. What do you want me to say? It's Prep and Landing. It's a cute Christmas story. I love these two shows. If you guys remember, let me know down in the comments. Maybe go check it out on Disney Plus. Show it some support. I checked out all the actors and stuff. They haven't really been in anything major since. I don't know, I think they both did a great job overall. It's not like they have extremely difficult material to work with, but their voices at least fit the characters very well, which I think is always important in an animated movie. I'm looking at you, Chris Pratt. You're a good actor, buddy, but you don't fit every animated character under the sun, okay? So, that's really all I got for you today. Thank you all so much for watching, and keep it crispy.
Outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of snow.